One thing that Vim users probably want to be able to do is to copy text from an external program into a running instance of Vim, or to copy text in Vim to an external program. And by default, Vim does not actually have this functionality. Vim has built-in copy and text in the form of the yank and paste commands, but those use Vim's built-in registers, which are distinct from the system clipboard that things like Firefox would use if you were to copy some text on an HTML page, for instance. However, there are ways to get Vim and the system clipboard to communicate. There are a few ways to do this, actually. One particular way was discussed by Luke Smith in a video he put out about a year ago. A very good video with a lot of great information. But his solution was to install gvim, or graphical Vim, which is a separate program that has a graphical version of Vim that runs outside of the terminal. But when you install gvim, it actually gives default Vim the functionality to access the system keyboard, or the system clipboard rather, with one of its registers. Now, we could do that. You could install gvim on Gentoo, but we are using Gentoo and we do have the access to use flags. So instead, it would be better to just give regular old Vim that functionality. And in fact, we can do that very easily with a single use flag. And the use flag that we actually want is the X use flag. Now, let's look and see what flags we have available. Let's emerge Vim. That's why the pretend option doesn't really matter, because we just want to see what flags we have available, right? Okay. Now, as you can see right now, the enabled use flags on my install of Vim are ACL and NLS. And right here you can see the dash X indicates that the X, the capital X option, is disabled. This means that Vim is compiled in such a way that it does not have access to Xorg or the X server, meaning that it doesn't have access to X server's terminal clipboard, which is what you copy and paste from in other programs that are running inside an X environment. Now, we can easily give it this functionality, and how we want to do that is we want to navigate to etc, portage, package.use directory. And this is the directory that's going to contain the files where we can determine on a program-by-program basis what use flags to enable. I covered this in one of my DWM videos a little bit, but we actually want to make a new file here to give specific use flag functionality to Vim. So we'll make a file here called Vim, sudo vim vim. Alright, and we want to put in the text app editors, which is the, editors, which is the category that Vim is under, Vim, which is the package name of Vim. Now, again, as I mentioned in one of my previous videos, when you attempt to emerge Vim, this category and the package name will be found, and any use flags that we list after this package and category will be enabled when the next compile happens. So we can simply enable the use flag X, capital X, right? And then we can right quit, get out, and we can try to emerge Vim again. About to sudo emerge it, because we actually want to successfully emerge it this time. Alright. It's calculating dependencies. Okay, there you go. And as you can see, the X flag has been enabled. It's green. It's got an asterisk beside it. That means it has been enabled since the last compile. So yes, we want to compile this. And now Vim will have access to the Xorg server, and it will have access to the Xterm clipboard. Take a moment to compile. Alright, and we're back. And Vim has compiled successfully. Now, if we want to check and see if it has Xterm clipboard capability enabled, the way to do that would be to run vim --version and then grep for the string clipboard. Alright, and as you can see, that indicates plus Xterm clipboard. That indicates that the Xterm clipboard functionality has been enabled in Vim. What this specifically means is that one of Vim's built-in registers, specifically the plus register, also known as the anonymous register, now corresponds with the system keyboard in the sense that a running instance of Vim will have access to the Xterm clipboard when you copy something to that particular register. And I can give you a quick demonstration of how that works. Right here I have a simple Python script. And let's say that I want to copy some text from this Python script that I have open in Vim over here to this scripter that is built into Krita, right? So the way that I would do that would be I would select it with visual mode like normal, but instead of just yanking with Y, I want to press double quote and then the plus sign and then Y. Now what the double quote is saying is copy to a specific register, and then the plus sign is saying copy to the plus register, and the plus register is the one that corresponds with the system clipboard. So now that I've done that, I can go over here to this and paste, and look at there. I've gotten the text from Vim. So I can do that with the entire document. Go down, select the whole thing, right? And double quote, plus yank. And we can go over here to this scripter, paste, and boom, we've got the entire thing. You can also, if you put something else into the clipboard, like let's say just a single line, right? That's different from what the clipboard was before. We can highlight that and copy it. Now we can go over here back to Vim. And if we want to paste from it, we do quotation mark. Oh, have to be outside of insert mode. Quotation mark plus the plus buffer and then P for paste. And boom, we paste from the anonymous buffer. And there you have it. That's really all there is to copy and pasting from Vim to external programs or from external programs into Vim. Now, obviously, those key presses are pretty cumbersome. So an alternative to doing that would be to remap a key chord to that command, which is easily done in your vimrc, which I've actually already done that in my home directory. I can open up my vimrc. As you can see, I have done that here. I have done a visual mode non-recursive mapping to control Y for yank to the plus buffer, and a visual mode non-recursive mapping to control D to cut to the plus buffer. And that's really all there is to it, to copying text to and from Vim. Hopefully this was helpful to you. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.